E. coli O157H7 produces a toxin when it's in the human body that is excreted from the bacteria, and if it enters the bloodstream, can cause severe illness. The normal illness that can be ascribed to E. coli O157 is hemolytic uremic syndrome, or HUS, and that has caused untold deaths and severe illness in the United States and, frankly, throughout the world. It is everywhere. It used to be thought of primarily still a reservoir in cattle, but we've been finding it in buffalo, sheep, goats, deer. They even found it in a trout in a lake. These are bacteria that are fecal in origin, that come from animals other than us, and that in our body doesn't tolerate them. E. coli and other bacteria are especially dangerous to the young and the elderly because in the young, their immune system is not fully developed. In the elderly, their immune system has been compromised. E. coli O157 symptoms are pretty classic. 3 to 4 days after the ingestion of the bacteria, it's cramping that'll then turn to bloody diarrhea. Bloody diarrhea is a hallmark of E. coli O157H7 infection. Most people recover. Some 90% of the people will, within 10 days, will start to get better, but it's a very horrible experience and very painful. 5 to 10% of people will go on to develop complications and may require hospitalization, and then a percentage of them will go on to develop acute kidney failure, and unfortunately sometimes death. For consumers, paying attention to where you're buying your food, handling it properly and cooking it thoroughly is the best thing you can do to protect your family, to think about the risky products that are out there: sprouts, hamburger, raw milk, leafy greens, things that have caused illness in the past. Make sure that if you're going to use those products, and some of them, frankly, I don't think you should, but if you're going to use those products, that you take extreme caution.